Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with a bit of an old, well, a bit of an old curiosity of a video, in that it's both my first foray into a new video style, a new video notion, as it were, as well as my birthday video. Yes, this day I turn 22. Or rather, this day when you're watching this, or when this is uploaded, at any rate. Yes, because of various engagements, I'm not actually capable of making a video on my birthday, because there is a reenactment training for a show early in December that I have to attend, so won't be there. So, yes, but what the notion... So, yes, happy birthday to me, hey? Let me just take a drink here. Because it's my birthday, I'm being very unprofessional and drinking my hot chocolate while I'm recording. There's a bit of advice for you, ladies and gentlemen. If you're ever doing anything strenuous on the vocal cords, a lot of roaring and a lot of shouting, or just a lot of talking, maybe a notion to get yourself a nice cup of hot chocolate. Cadbury's hot drinking chocolate is my preference. Bit of hot semi-skimmed milk with some chocolate in there. It's fucking delicious. This shit saw me through my job at Scream Factory. Anyway, yes, what this notion is essentially I go through a game. A game that I've had for a while, but haven't necessarily played all that much of, and basically play the first half hour or so of it. And you watch as well. Not sure what I'll call this. I mean, this one's probably not going to have the series name, because it's a bit of a special one, because it's my birthday video. But yeah, so that's the basic notion, having a go of a game I really should have played already. This time we're doing a game that's a bit of a cheat. I'm cheating already, in that it is a game I haven't played enough of, but it is one I've played a decent amount of in years past. But I've never gotten particularly far, because I'm terrible with CRPGs. This game is goes by the name of Arcanum, of Steamworks and Magick Obscura. Also, I'm not sure, but there may be a bit of a weirdness going on up here with the fraps counter. Sometimes CRPGs are a bit odd about fraps, so my apologies if there's any curiosities there, but Arcanum of Steamworks and Magick Obscura. If you don't know what Arcanum of, let me just go pardon me here. Actually, no, this is kind of Victorian, so we'll go Mr. Partner. But yes, Arcanum of Steamworks and Magick Obscura, for those of you who don't know, is, I want to say, a Sierra-made CRPG, released in the early 2000s, I believe, with a rather curious... Yeah, this is always the weird thing when it comes to the half... I tend to play a half-orc in this game, and I always like the first face. Don't know why. There's something very half-orc-y about it. But, yes, it's a game, and it's kind of a steampunk affair. Well, a mixture of steampunk and magic as, just a minute here. Delicious. So I'm just trying to pick it. But yes, it's a mixture of steampunk and magic aesthetics. I don't actually know much more about the plot there, but that's the basic setting. A mixture of steampunk and magic aesthetics, with a rather strong focus, as you may have been able to pick up from the title, on how the technology and the magic mix, or rather, how they don't. I'm just trying to find one that gives me intelligence, because I'm gonna play a mage. I'm just gonna play a mage. Mr. Partner, sold your soul. Yeah, sure. Let's go with the half-orc who sold his soul. Sure. Gives me an excuse to hurt people, I suppose. Need more willpower. Lovely. Okay. But yeah, so I do have a bit of a history with this game, as it were. In that, I played the shit out of this. We're definitely gonna need charm if we've sold our soul. But yes, I used to play the shit out of this when I was younger. Curiously, I picked it up of all places in a pound shop. A strange place to pick up a game, but it's where I got it. I just randomly happened upon it in a pound shop, and I have I did deeply enjoy it. But with many things, I had kind of a strange approach to games. When I was younger, in that, yeah, let's go with that, I'm trying to think how best to describe my approach to games when I was younger. I approached them very much as toys, more than anything else, which did, I can't afford it, fair enough. Which did kind of lead to this strange mentality, where, or this strange situation where I would almost never complete any of the games I owned. I would just bugger about with them and never actually get anywhere. Arcanum is one that definitely suffered from that, so I am very familiar with the relatively early parts of the game, the parts of the game we're going to be playing, but I've never really seen much beyond that. In case you're interested in the storyline, I will basically skip through a lot of this. I'm going to just bounce through this. I will quickly sum up for you if you're interested. In essence, we were on a Zeppelin.
I mean, you and then the Zeppelin and...
You know, I'll let this explain. But
and the altar says that... Do you have any idea what all of this means?
Long story short, we were on a Zeppelin and we were given a ring by a gnome. One thing I always did deeply enjoy about this game, actually, was the kind of curious approach to customization. Yes, you can customize your character in a varying number of ways. You can play an outright big, smashy bastard, typically best if you're playing an ogre or an orc. You can play a kind of small, roguey type. You can play a charismatic, speaky type, which tends to be my personal favorite. Although, having said that, we are currently playing just an outright mage, so fuck knows what I'm doing over here. But other than just those basic things, you can also actually give your character a background, which makes slight alterations. And it does go into actually some intense detail about that. I'm not sure. Yes, because we're in a dialogue. We can't actually look at those right now. But that is something I always quite liked. I'm not sure how much they come into play as the game goes on. I'd kind of hope, but I'm not sure whether or not this is the case, that in the main storyline, if you have sold your soul, that would have some effect beyond that. But, there you go. Oh dear. Lovely little game. Although it does always, if I recall correctly, leave very vague what it is you were doing on the Zeppelin. I also, honestly, just adore the way this game is written. Because it is very, what ho, tally pip, what? You know, it's very kind of stereotypically kind of Georgian and Victorian in a lot of its dialogue, which is deeply enjoyable, as is expected of the steampunk genre, but it plays it weirdly straight. A lot of the time, it does lead to a lot of colourful dialogue and colourful characters. I especially love some of the ludicrous options, as it were, the douchebag options. You know, like, it's like, I can't believe it. Do you have any idea what this means? It's just like, my God, I was died in there. Didn't you see the crash?
You speak. I mean, of course you speak. What am I, a blathering idiot? Wait, what did you say? Maybe I should be writing all of this down.
And this guy is if I recall correctly, the voice acting in this game kind of wavers a bit, but I've always liked this chap. His name's Virgil, and he's your first companion, and if I recall correctly from what I played, I think he sticks with you for quite a length of the game. I don't know if he ever actually leaves you without being told. Lovely chap, lovely. Oh dear. You know what?
Please forgive me,
be rude, blah yes, blah blah, yeah, blah. Right. I am gonna skip through this.
No, but I would like to, the path out of.
Yes, I'm gonna skip through this. I was gonna skip through that purely for ease, so we don't spend too long arsing around in it. Because as I said, we are going to be. Oh shit! I forgot something. Actually, no. You know, I won't have auto run on. I will just wander around. I will just hold the button down to run. And let me just quickly equip my spells here. Put charm over here in the utility section, if I may. If I may. Lovely. And also slap this fella down here. But yeah, so I won't actually let you see too much of the story for the simple reason that this is only, you know, this is one half-hour video. You don't want to be seeing everything. Now, what I'm just quickly doing here is kind of something which I imagine... What? Ah! Wolves! Die! Good. But it's something... Sorry about that. Wolves! Die! Good. But it's something that I imagine is quite familiar to those of you who have played CRPGs in the past. That being desperately trying to find anything that might be of value that's hidden in an annoying place. For this particular one, you might want to grab this camera. Just a suggestion. Also, I quite like this. I'm sorry, this is not a good example of my notion for this series. Yeah, again, you just get rumors and just the writing. I just love the writing in this game. I'm trying to think. I could have sworn there was a place you could read your background. Oh well, perhaps he just didn't write it down, or perhaps I've gone mad. But yeah, it is kind of rather tempting to just vanish immediately. Also, it must be said, this is actually quite a novel system, to my mind. That yes, and you can quite literally plot dots on a map for where you're going, and as long as you hold control when you hit run, you will fucking sprint there. Lovely, lovely. Shit, it's alive! Not anymore, it isn't. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. But there is just so much to like about this game. And yet it's actually one of, to my understanding, it's one of the less well-known CRPGs of its time. I grant a good part of that might be because it's got a bloody odd title. I mean, it's also honestly one of my favorite titles of any game ever. You know, Arcanum of Steamwork and Magick. We've hit something of a jackpot, my lads. Hey. I mean, we can't wear these, but fuck me, no, I understand. We can't wear those, and we need to get them identified, but let's trade it. There you go. But by God, those are probably a bit valuable. So, you know, some bits of armor. Gotta love them. Yeah, it has got something of an odd title, something of a curious notion, and it's not exactly connected to any famous series. So this is a relatively obscure CRPG of the time, at least to my understanding, but a deeply enjoyable one. One thing that I imagine would cause some division of opinion, but it's something that I'm quite fond of, as you may notice here. I mean, obviously you've got your standard skills, your technological disciplines, and your magic disciplines. Also, as I believe I said, there is a distinct measure of tech to magic. See, here I am skewed towards magic. This does actually have an effect in-game. For the longest time, I thought, well, perhaps it just means that if you have, say, very high tech, obviously you can't use magic, and if you've got very high magic, tech isn't that useful. No. At one point, I'm age 15. That does not look like a 15-year-old. That's the ugliest 15-year-old in history. Eh, whatever. Let's say he's an orc and he develops quicker. But, let me just take another sip here. Lovely. But, one thing that I absolutely adored, I wish I could show you it, but I don't have the save anymore. I actually played a halfling wizard for quite some time, and then, just as an experiment, tried to use a gun to see what would happen. It didn't end well. His arm got blown off. The gun exploded and took my character's arm with it. Because that's just the kind of game this is. The amount of attention to detail it puts in is something I absolutely adore. To the point of which, there's also a number of spells, which some of them are a bit irritating, and I'm not sure exactly why this is. This is why I actually went in here. There are ones with obvious use, such as harm, minor healing. There's ones with like slightly less obvious uses, like mage lock that locks doors. Disarm, sense alignment, these sorts of things. Purity of water, etc., etc. Really? There's a spell that raises the target creature's beauty? Really? Anyway. Yeah, there are all these various spells, but then you also notice things like call fog, and wall of fire, and wall of stone, and conjure spirit. And things of that nature. Flash. You do just notice a lot of these oddities. There's a lot of kind of strange spells in the game. Which honestly, I find quite entertaining. Because Conjure Spirit, so far as I can tell, has absolutely zero fucking use in the entire game. Conjure Spirit, so far as I can tell, is basically, you are a dick, I'm torturing a dead man. Because all that happens is a spirit raises out of the ground and complains. I mean, one hopes that at some point there is a chap. Perhaps it can be used for important NPCs. One doesn't know. One hopes that it's such that important NPCs can be rezzed in this way. And spoken to, but if that's the case, it's the first I've heard of it. If it's the case, I've never seen it happen. You do see, effect. You do one. You do see effects. Let me fucking. There you go. You do see effects similar to conjure spirit. In fact, we're going to see one shortly. But I actually, at one point, made a point of rezzing basically everything I killed, even killing certain trying to kill certain NPCs and raise them, and it achieved me zip, nothing, nada. Got nothing from it. I'm trying to think here what... You know what, I'm gonna get Plague of Insects. Slurs the token creature. Just so next level I can get Orcish Champion, because being able to summon an orc up would be damned helpful, one imagines. Oh, I keep forgetting you have to actually friggin'... Oh, shit. I can see you. Well, I know you're there. I just can't see you. Come on. Let's have you. There you go. See, this is what Conjure Spirit looks like. But yeah, no, my whole point about the spells is that there are a number of spells that are useless, but can't add to the world. What the fuck's Hellgate? Someone's a demon. Jesus. Yeah, like, here we go. Wall of Fire. As far as I can tell, this doesn't do anything. Like, at all. It doesn't appear to damage anyone if they move over it. Granted, this is my experiences before the patches. I'm currently actually using an unofficial patch that came out many years after the game was released. So maybe this does do something now. Wall of Stone, as far as I can tell, just stops them from moving. Where's the other one? Here it is. Call Fog. Fuck knows. Doesn't do anything, as far as I can tell. Charm isn't all that useful. You know, there's a number of these spells that just don't really seem to me do anything. Don't seem particularly worthwhile, and yet the game gives you them regardless. There's something enjoyable to me about the fact that these things exist in the game. These, like, useless, superfluous things exist. I'm gonna, you know, to save you from reading all this and save me from reading it all out, basically, chap was cursed by an evil priest. His friend was cursed with madness and attacked him, and he's asking for our help. Of course, we're gonna point out here that if you were alive, you would be spitting on me, because half-orcs are deeply hated in this setting. I protest the treatment of orcs and half-orcs when I still lived. I was a man of peace and respect. I'm still unsure. Why should I help you? Tell you something valuable. Valuable information will you impart. Know of a treasure. You know of this treasure. And now he says he's a monk. Certain, but I will do this for you regardless. Yes. We're also going to sleep in his bed. Because we can. By the way, spoilers, this guy ain't on the up and up. If that wasn't immediately apparent, this guy ain't on the up and up.
What is it that you want of me?
You know, I'm actually going to... There you go. You can be weighed down, Virgil. I don't want to be weighed down. I ain't gonna be weighed down by no man. Single orc. Doing it for himself. Let's bugger off over here, shall we? Yeah, that chap isn't on the up and up. Not sure which version of the quest we will actually end up doing, though, for the simple reason that we are evil already. You know what I mean? It seems a bit pointless to go around doing good things if I'm always going to be a certain amount of evil.
The altar should... I'm sorry.
And just skip through that. My notion is I'm actually going to show you the end of that little side quest, and then I'm going to call it a video. What are you doing here? What do you recommend?
Dealt with sluggers. Fine.
I am going to deliberately antagonize this man.
This man was a hired.
Hired killer, blah de blah. This is all relating to the main conspiracy of the plotline. Let's bugger off towards Albabara's house, the chap who apparently cursed the other two chaps. So, actually, I do wonder how difficult this man is to kill. I've never actually tried, come to think of it. Oh, not very. He has nothing worthwhile on him, though. And I didn't save the game, so I might have just killed him. Ah, well. Basically, what actually happened is here, beloved wife and mother, beloved son. Basically, that chap who was clearly not on the up and up, being not on the up and up as he was lying. He was cursed by this priest after having killed his family. I believe he does still tell you where the treasure is, though. If I recall correctly. I think you can then sell it. Run. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. But yes, if you talk to the priest, you are then tasked with returning, and you can actually convince him that if you can convince the bandit, if he doesn't tell you where the stuff, where his friend has taken the item, he will never be cursed. I've completed your task. What's so amusing? Tell me where the treasure located. Oh, he doesn't. That cheating bastard. Huh. But I actually know where he is. Then, such is the nature of CRPGs. Sometimes you take the wrong choice, and you bugger yourself over eternally. And I have rather dramatically buggered myself over eternally, so I can't actually show you the end of that quest. Oh dear. But yes, so I enjoy this game. I do intend, I'm not actually going to continue playing this character. I'm going to make something else. I'm thinking a technological halfling, perhaps. Or a gnome. Or maybe a magic dwarf. You know what? I've decided I'm making a magic dwarf. I've never played a dwarf in this game. But yeah, so I just quite enjoy this game. Honestly, I would recommend to you ladies and gentlemen that you pick it up if you're a fan of CRPGs and want something with a setting that's a little different. I mean, it does have elements of your standard fantasy setting, but it's almost your standard fantasy setting several hundred years later after the Industrial Revolution, and it does it well as opposed to the other game that does it after this, I can think of off the top of my head that makes it a fantasy setting after the Industrial Revolution, that being Fable 3, which fucking sucked. But yeah, so, can't think of anything else to witter on about it right now, so there you go. But yes, I enjoy this game. If you're interested in picking it up, I would suggest GOG.com. That's the version I'm using right now, and getting the unofficial patches could, well, certainly it wouldn't hurt, would it? But yeah, no, I believe that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Cyrus Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a really shitty day when I recorded that. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. Anyway, just here to say that I have a Twitter account that you can follow if you want occasional updates of random thoughts from me, and that if you're feeling generous, feel free to donate to my Patreon campaign. Every penny donated there makes life easier for me generally and slowly goes towards me getting a better gaming PC. Well, that's that. It's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.